Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's video, we are going to address the elephant in the room, the fly on the wall. Where are the men in OT? I want to know, where are they? Where? How come there's not a lot of men in occupational therapy? We are going to finally address it in this video. Today, this video is a collab video. I have today in our presence Tad from Tap In with Tad. Welcome our guest to the channel.
What's up, y'all? My name is Ted from the Tap In with Ted channel. I'm an occupational therapy student, and I'm super excited to do this video on the lack of men in occupational therapy with the lovely OT, Miss Nancy.
We will be discussing the why there's a lack of men in OT and how we can bridge the gap. I think my program had about 4 men in total in my whole entire class, and we had 35 people. That's not even, what, a quarter. That's not even 2% of my class. So the number was very, very low. The majority of OTs and coders are women. Now, Ted, what do you think about that?
That's actually spot on with my class as well. There are only 4 men of 41 students in the program. When I was racking up observation hours, I only came across 2 male OTs, 1 in the skilled nursing facility and 1 in hand therapy. Those were actually the only men that I met in OT at the time.
I don't believe that OT is a female job. I honestly feel like we need a lot of men in OT. Both men and women need therapy, right? It's not that only women need therapy and men don't need therapy. A lot of the patients that I see are mixed. The ratio is mixed. There's probably a lot more males than females sometimes, depending on the situation. And sometimes I wish that we did have a lot more men in OT, because then I feel like a lot of the patient would be a lot more comfortable with a male OT than a female OT. And I also feel like a lot of the patient would be a lot more comfortable to be opened up about certain topics more than they will be with me. Some of the female patients relate a lot better with the males than they do with the females. That's just how it works sometimes. Even me as a female, I have a lot more male friends than I do female friends. It's always been like that, which could definitely help with the therapeutic process. So it's important that we get more men in the field. OT is not a female-only field.
I agree with you, Nancy. It's important to know that OTs serve a very diverse population of different genders and ethnic groups. So, of course, there are some occupations that male OTs may be very helpful at assisting male clients who need occupational therapy. Some very obvious examples include shaving or urinating. There also are times where patients who may be bigger may need to be transferred from one surface to another, such as from a bed to a chair or just general bed mobility. The patient may very well be more comfortable being transferred by a strong male occupational therapist. Now, that's not to say that women aren't strong at all, but I think you catch my drift. Realistically, all jobs need to be diversified to help patients be more comfortable and receive the care that they need. Most people may perceive OT as a more feminine profession only because of the aspect of self-care, and PT may be perceived as more manly only because of the name. Physical therapy. But this is a very wrong perception. Occupational therapists treat way more than just self-care. Self-care is a very small fraction of what OTs do. But even so, men still take care of themselves, so men still need self-care. Typically, men are thought to work very long hours at work doing a very strenuous job, and this can take a toll on a multitude of occupations. For instance, sleep and rest. They might not sleep enough or rest enough, especially if they have different types of injuries or conditions that they're dealing with. So sleep is something that we can help men with. Depending on what conditions or injuries that men may be dealing with, we may also modify their home as well. Home modifications can help men adapt to their current level of functioning based on what injury or condition they have, or if it's a condition or injury that they won't completely get rid of, it can also be a permanent home modification that they need, such as a wheelchair ramp, handrails to go up the stairs, which I believe every pair of stairs should have, grab bars in the tub and shower, elevated toilet seat, etc., etc.
So how do we diversify OT and encourage men to apply and get into the field? I think one of the ways that we can accomplish this is to get a lot more men involved in the OT community, to allow their voices to be heard, to allow their voices to be heard outside of their daily routines as OT. I don't even think there's a lot of OT men like on YouTube or even making their presence known on other social media networks. People need mentors. They need people to encourage them to be able to get to where they are, to be able to see that this is not a female failed. This is a man failed. This man, whatever you identify with, you can be an OT. It does not have to be all females. If you're male, female, if you don't identify with either or, you can be an OT. And that message needs to be talked about and discussed a lot more. What do you think, Ted?
That's an excellent suggestion, which is why I started my channel, Tap In With Ted. There are many undergraduate men that are looking for the content that I'm creating. I know because I was there too, trying to choose between occupational therapy, physical therapy, and athletic training. Thankfully, I did enough research outside of YouTube about what occupational therapy is and the populations that they serve. But I think it's very helpful to advocate and create content to educate men that occupational therapy is much more than just self-care. Since occupations are so diverse, there are plenty of other examples of how you can help other men get back to the occupations that they've always loved.
Well, there you have it, man. We need you. OT needs you. Come on down to occupational therapy. We accept all people regardless of sex, race, ethnicity, sexual orientation. It does not matter. We need a lot more diversity. We need to diversify OT. I will leave all of our contact information down below, including Ted's contact information, if you want to contact Ted and talk about the process of becoming an OT. If you have any further questions, go ahead and DM me on Instagram or send me an email. I'll leave all of my information down below. Thank you guys so much for watching this. If you love this collaboration and you want to see a lot more videos of Ted and I, definitely let us know what kind of videos you would like us to make together. Also, Ted has his own YouTube channel. I'm going to leave that information down below. Go ahead and check out his channel. Follow, subscribe, and support him. Okay? And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.